Hello students, in this video we are going to first discuss about the TCS digital hiring pattern for 2021 batch, and then we will check out some sample problems of TCS digital from quantitative aptitude section. So first let me clear some confusion among students about the words TCS NQT, TCS Ninja and TCS digital. So NQT is nothing but National Qualifier Test, and Ninja and digital are these two job roles. Okay, these are the two job roles. So Ninja, it is 3.5 lakhs per annum is offered under Ninja job role, and under digital 7 lakhs per annum is offered. Okay, so these are nothing but two job roles, so don't confuse it with NQT. NQT is nothing but the name of the test, that is National Qualifier Test. NQT Ninja and NQT digital, so these are the two job roles. Okay, so currently TCS has launched its digital drive only for the premium institutes. Now these premium institutes are decided by TCS, and if your college is a TCS premium institute, your training and placement head will tell you about it. So TCS NQT for Ninja role is not launched yet by TCS, and once it launches we will tell you about it. Last year TCS NQT for Ninja role, this particular opportunity was available to all the colleges in our country, all the engineering colleges. Okay, but this particular drive, this digital drive, is only applicable for the premium institutes currently. So once the TCS launch its NQT for Ninja role, we'll definitely tell you about it. Now, the new pattern for TCS digital has been already conveyed by TCS to the training and placement head of various premium colleges. But some YouTube channels boast of having partnership with the company, and that's why they got the pattern. I don't know why they do that, but this TCS digital pattern is given to the training placement officers of these premium institutes already. So now let's check the pattern. Now let's check what was the old pattern. So this was basically the old pattern: English 10 minutes, 15 questions around, quantitative aptitude 30 minutes with 15 questions, programming logic of 25 minutes with 10 to 12 questions, and coding 60 minutes with just one question. Now this is the new pattern. They have divided the new pattern into two parts, that is part A and part B, and in that you can check programming logic MCQ. Okay, this has been eliminated this time, so that particular section is not there. They have just focused on English, quantitative aptitude and coding. So English is for 10 minutes. So if you compare with last year's pattern, in 10 minutes they might ask 10 to 15 questions. Okay, in quantitative aptitude last year it was 30 minutes and 15 questions were asked. This time it is 40 minutes, so maybe we can consider 20 questions to be asked in this 40 minutes. And coding is for again 60 minutes, in which one coding question can be asked. Now this pattern is already given to the training and placement officers of the premium institutes, as you can check on the screen. This is the screenshot of the PDF which is provided to the training and placement officer. Now those students who are not a part of premium college, you need to wait for TCS NQT Ninja drive, because this particular drive will be launched soon. You can check on the screen. I have shown you the screenshot in which the TCS has clearly mentioned that they are going to launch the dates soon for the TCS NQT All India level drive. So All India level drive is nothing but the Ninja drive. So all students, I really ask you to start your preparation immediately, okay? And don't wait for the drive to be launched, because there will be a lot of less time for preparation after that. So make sure you are starting your preparation from right now. If you have genuinely liked the way we share placement preparation opportunities, preparation videos and off-campus updates, then do like and comment on this video. We are not asking you to comment for any free course or free test pack. We already have a lot of free tests and material on our website. So now without wasting much time, let us check out some of the sample questions of TCS Digital from the quantitative aptitude section.
ABC are real numbers in a geometric progression such that mod of ABC is equal to 15. The median of these three numbers or three terms is A and B equal to 10. If A is greater than C, what is the product of the first four terms of this geometric progression, GP? Very important thing, okay? Please pay attention to basic concepts over here. I understand you know geometric progression, okay? But still there are some things which are important, and it is based on basic things. Sum is actually very easy, but still, since we are slightly unaware of the basics, we make mistake. A, B, C are real numbers, okay? So, and they are in a geometric progression. So now over here, A, B and C, if they are in geometric progression, generally what happens? A is smaller than B, b smaller than c, and the median, that means sort of average, not exactly average. Average is the word generally used for arithmetic progression, non-normal averages, but the median over here is generally b. The middle term is generally the median. The middle term is always generally, or most of the times, 99% times, it is the median. Okay, it is the median, the middle term. Even if the progression is like this, say for example 10 1 0.1, which is like decreasing, or if it is like 0.1 1 10 increasing, still the middle term is going to be the median. Okay, whatever be the case, middle term is going to be median. Here the problem is median is the first term A. So why this has happened? This has happened because the common ratio R is less than zero, that is common ratio is negative. That is the reason median is not the middle term. Okay, now I'll prove it to you, sort of on what basis I'm making this assumption. Okay, because whenever in exam or if you encounter such sum, you should be able to understand why the common ratio I've taken as negative. First of all, let us assume that A is greater than zero and R, that is the common ratio, is greater than one. Now, please understand, before writing A, R, everything, I'll tell you how a geometric progression is written on the right hand side. Take a look over here. First term will be A, common ratio is R, so second term will be AR, third term will be AR square, fourth term will be AR cube, and so on. Okay, now very important thing, maybe you know this, maybe you don't, but still I'll tell you again. What term will come before AR? Over here you are multiplying by R. Okay, but if you go in reverse, you are sort of dividing by R, because of which RR gets cancelled, you get A. Here also divide by R, then you'll get AR. Divide by R, you'll get AR. So here also you'll divide by R and you'll get A upon R. Again, divide by R, you'll get A upon R square. So basically this is a geometric progression series. Okay, A is the first term. Okay, if A is the first term, this is second, third, fourth. Or you can start, this is the first term, multiply by R, you get A by R. Multiply by R, you get A, multiply by R, A. So first term, second term, third term, fourth term, fifth term. You can do that way also. Okay, this gets continued. This is a geometric progression. Now, assume that A is greater than zero and R is greater than one. Not only positive, but it is also greater than one. What is going to happen? A, AR, AR square. Okay, let this be term A, B and C. This will be greater than this and this will be greater than this. B will be greater than A, C will be greater than B, and B will become the middle term, that is the median. You can try it for any of the geometric progressions, okay, where A is greater than 0 and R is greater than 1. If A is greater than 0 and R lies between 0 and 1, that means R is positive, but it lies between 0 and 1. Still, what is going to happen? B is going to be the median between A and C. Only difference would be what? Here A, B and C. R is sort of a fraction, like 0.5, like this is decimal, okay? 0.1, 0.5 or 1 by 2, 1 by 4, like that. R is a fraction between 0 and 1. Only in this case, A will be greater than B and B will be greater than C. The geometric progression goes down like this. This is an example where R is less than 1 but greater than 0. In this case also, A is greatest, C is the lowest and B is the median. So for R positive, you are always going to get middle term as the median. Now, let us take A as negative. Okay, A is negative, A is not positive, A is negative. For this case also, if you see R greater than 1 and R between 0 and 1, you'll get the same, conditions. Okay, in the first case, like R greater than 1, what will happen is A, B and C. A will be greater and C will be the lowest. And B will come in the middle. For R between 0 and 1, A will be the lowest, C will be the greatest, okay, and B will still come in the middle, okay, exactly opposite to the positive ones. But still in all the cases, B is the median. Very important. So there is only one condition where B is not median, that is R is less than 1, that is negative. You will get to know why I'm saying that this becomes negative and all that stuff. So sorry, less than zero. So whenever R is negative, then only the median is not the middle term. Over here, what they've given is A is the median. Okay. And they have also given the term B's value, that is 10. So now I'll write the geometric progression. It would be 10. Common ratio is R. Okay. Next term will be 10R. Previous term will be 10 divided by r, correct? 10 upon r, 10 and 10r. These would be three terms based on this, right? Now what they have given, I'll write over here. Check out over here on the left hand side. A plus b plus c, mod of this is 15. If r value or common ratio is negative, this mod, okay, a plus b plus c, value of this can never be positive. Value of this, okay, can never be positive. This always has to be negative. And that is the reason when we take mod, this negative gets converted to positive. Okay. Mod of a plus b plus c is 15. Normal value of a plus b plus c is not necessarily 15. It can be positive 15 or negative 15. But since common ratio r is negative, check out over here. If b is 10, c will be something in negative because r is negative. A will also be negative. So addition of two negatives, one positive, it will generally come out to be minus 15. So what we get is a plus b plus c comes out to be minus 15. So that I'll apply over here. That comes out to be minus 15. So multiply by r throughout. What do I get is 10 plus 10r plus 10r square would be equal to minus 15r. So I get 10r square plus 25r plus 10 would be equal to 0. That comes out to be 2r square plus 5r plus 2 would be equal to 0. So product has to be 4 and summation has to be 5r. Okay. So what can we have over here? The factors on solving you get as r is equal to minus 2 and r is equal to minus 1 by 2. Actually, it does not come like this. I made an error over here while calculation. If you try to solve this, okay, if you try to solve this, this entire thing, the answer that you are going to get over here is factors directly, I'll tell you, r equal to minus 2 and r equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, the factors that you are going, we tell right over here, r equal to minus 2 and r equal to minus 1 by 2. You get two values of r because this is going to be a quadratic equation. I won't waste time over here solving the quadratic equation. This you can do later on. So for this equation, on solving, it will become a quadratic, and for quadratic, you are going to get two roots. Either r is minus 2 or r is minus 1 by 2. Now, if r is minus 2, what will be the three terms? 10 upon minus 2 will be what? Minus 5. 10. And 10 into minus 2 is minus 20. Correct? And if r is minus 1 by 2, 10 upon minus 1 by 2 will be minus 20. 10. And 10 into minus 1 by 2 is minus 5. So either the sequence is minus 5, 10, minus 20. This is A, this is B, this is C. Or it is A, B, C. But they have given A is greater than C. So minus 5 is greater than minus 20. So R has to be equal to minus 2 only. And this must be the sequence. Minus 5, 10 and minus 20. So what are the first four terms? Minus 5, 10, minus 20. And then next will be, it is 10R. So next will be 10R square. 10 into R square. What is R? R is minus 2. 10 into minus 2 square is 10 into 4. That is 40. These are the first four terms. And we want the product of these four terms. You multiply these. What do we get? 40 into 20 is 80. Minus minus comes out to be positive. So 5 tens are 50. 5 into 20 comes out to be 100. And into 10 is 1000 into 40, that comes out to be 40,000 as the answer, right? That is option A. Very easy. Actual sum is over here only. Problem that happens is because the median is A, we are not able to understand that R is negative in this case. So to understand that is the reason I taught you the basics and told you that, okay, why R comes out to be negative? Just directly telling you that R is negative is not useful. You should understand this because later on you might be able to use this technique or this knowledge somewhere else in some other sum. Okay. So over here, the common ratio which is there is negative. That is the reason we are getting the median to be not as the middle term. The median is different. Okay. So next time while solving, this is going to be really easy for you. This will hardly take you like 1 minute. Okay. That minute is also for determining that, okay, this is negative. So we can have this as the entire sequence and then solving and getting the quadratic. You'll hardly need 1 to 2 minutes to solve this sum. And when you get the four terms, you can just multiply and get the answer as 40,000. Okay. Let's move on to the next sum. Consider the set S 8, 5, 1, 13, 34, 3, 21, 2. These are elements of the set. Akshay lists all two element subsets of S and takes the larger of the elements in each set. So what does Akshay does is he lists all the two element subsets. That means how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Out of these 8, what he makes is subsets of two elements each. Like for example, he'll make a group of 2, 8 and 5. Okay. Then he'll make 8 and 1. Then he'll make 8 and 13. Then he'll make 8 and 34. Like this, for every element, he'll make a group. He'll make a subset of S. 8 and say after 13, it is 34 and so on. Same way for 5 and 8 or 5 and 1, 5 and 13, he'll be doing that. Right? Now 8 and 5 and 5 and 8 is the same thing. So he won't repeat that. And out of that, he takes the largest of the elements in the set. So out of this, what is the largest? 8. Here also 8 is largest. Here 13 is the largest. Here 34 is the largest. He takes only the largest number. If he sums all these numbers, that is, he is adding these numbers, the sum he will obtain is, now this looks really complicated, but this answer can be obtained in round about 40 to 50 seconds. Very easy. Okay, pay attention over here. First of all, what he does is he combines any two elements and makes a set of it. Any two elements makes a set, and he makes it like all the possible sets which are there. He lists all of them. That is, he writes down all of them. Then he takes only the largest of the values. So best way to solve this sum is arrange all these numbers in increasing order. First one will come, then two, then three will come, then five, then eight, 13 is there, then 21, and then 34. Okay. Now, pay attention carefully. Very easy. First, we'll make the sets of number 34. Like we'll make a set of two numbers in which one number compulsorily is 34. Okay. Other number will change. Between 34 and 21, which is the greatest? 34. Between 34 and 13? 34. 34 and 8? 34. 34 and 5? 34. 34 and 3? 34. 34 and 2? 34. And 34 and 1? Again, greatest is 34 only. And we have to add all of those. How many numbers are these? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 times 34. Plus. Now 34, all sets of 34 are over. Forget it. All sets of 21. 21 and 34. Already we know 34 we have taken over here only. Okay, which is greater. So forget that. Only check the lowest ones that we have done. 21 and 34, we have already taken 34 as the greatest. Check out the lowest ones. For 21, 21 will be greater than this, 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 all of these. So how many times 21? It will be 6 times. Plus for 13, set with 21 already done, set with 34 already done. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sets are possible. Okay, that are remaining, and all of them 13 is greatest. So 5 into 13 plus for 8, 4 sets are possible, and all of them 8 is the greatest. For 5, 3 sets are possible, and all of them 5 is greatest. For 3, 2 sets are possible, and in that 3 is the greatest. For 2, only one set is possible. Okay, this, and in which 2 is the greatest. On multiplying, what do you get? 2 plus 2 3s are 6, plus 3 5s are 15, 4 8s are 32, 13 5s are 65, 21 6s are 126. 7 into 34 comes out to be some 7 4s are 28, 7 3s are 21 plus 2, 238. On adding all of these, you get the answer as 484 as the summation. Very easy. Just arrange it in the increasing order and then start making the sets just like Akshay does. Only thing is Akshay is doing donkey work and then taking greatest number from each of the set. We'll do smart work. For 34, first we'll start with number 34 instead of starting with 8. 34, first set will be with 21. So 34 and 21 is the first set, out of which 34 is greatest. Next set is 34 and 13. In that also 34 is greatest. Next set is 34 and 8. In that also 34 is greatest. Next set is 34 and 5. In that also 34 is greatest. 34 and 3, 34 greatest. 34 and 2, 34 and 1. Still, everywhere 34 is greatest. So in all these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 sets, 34 is greatest. So 34 is to be added 7 times. So 7 into 34. For 21, there will be six possible sets, because not seven, why six? Because 21 and 34, this set already over here. No need to repeat, answer is going to be 34 only. Okay, so that we have already counted. So forget that. So 21, say how many times? Six times will be counted. It will be greatest in six sets. 13 will be greatest in five sets. Okay, these five. 8 will be greatest in four sets. 8 will be greatest in these four sets. 5 will be greatest in these three sets. 3 will be greatest in these two sets. And 2 will be greatest only in the set 2 and 1. Right? Addition comes out to be 484. Let's move on. If 12 divides AB 313 AB in decimal notations, where AB are digits greater than 0, the smallest value of A plus B is. Now, if a number is divisible by 2, you should know the divisibility test of 12. Actually, even if you don't remember divisibility test of 12, it is fine. I'll tell you how to, whenever they give something, how to find the divisibility test. If we want something to be divisible by 12, write factors of 12 such that those two factors will have nothing in common with it. 6 multiplied by 2 is 12, but here 3 is common between them. Okay, both of them can be divisible by 2 and 1. So there is one common factor still apart from 1. So we cannot take this. 3 into 4, only common factor is 1. Both of them can be divisible by only 1. There is no other common factor. Take these factors. If the given number is divisible by 3 and 4, it is divisible by 12. Very easy. Take another example. Find the divisibility test for 99. We can write 11 into 9 is 99. They have nothing in common apart from 1. They are co-prime to each other. If a number is divisible by 11 and it is divisible by 9, the number is divisible by 99. Very easy trick. So if this number is divisible by 12, that means this number is divisible by 3 as well as 4. Now, write the number over here. This is divisible by 4, this entire number. That means the last two digits have to be divisible by 4. That means the last two digits can be 04, 08, 12, 16, 20. That is a table of 12, table of 4, 24, 28, so on, anything. Let us try to check. Okay, if the last two digits are 04, then it is divisible by 4. But A and B are greater than 0. So A cannot be equal to 0. Here also A cannot be equal to 0. Now, let last two digits be 12. So A is this, B is this. Now, this number is divisible by 4. Why? Because last two digits are nothing but 1 and 2. That is 12. How to check whether it is divisible by 3? Add all the digits and that should be divisible by 3. A is 1, B is 2, plus 3, plus 1, plus 3. Again, AB, plus 1, plus 2. What do you get is 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 3 is 9, 10, 11, 13, which is not divisible by 3. So 12 cannot be the answer. Let the last two digits be 16. Okay? Let the last two, it's not 6. Answer is not 6. Answer is 7, option A. If the last two digits are 16, A will be 1, B will be 6. So what is the addition now? A will be 1, B will be 6, plus 3, plus 1, plus 3, plus 1, plus 6. So that comes out to be 6 plus 3 is 9, 6 plus 3 is 9, 18, 19, 20, 21. 21 is divisible by 3, 3 into 7, 21. So last two digits has to be 1 and 6. AB has to be 1 and 6. A plus B comes out to be 1 plus 6, that is 7. Answer is option A. Okay, very easy, not that difficult. Don't worry, don't panic at all. Right, let's move on to the next sum. A and B stand at distinct points of a circular race track of length 120 meters. They run at speeds of A meters per second and B meters per second respectively. They meet for the first time 16 seconds after they start the race and for the second time 40 seconds from the time they start the race. Now, if B had started in the opposite direction to the one he had originally started, they would have met for the first time after 40 seconds. If B is quicker than A, find B's speed. Over here, this looks slightly complicated, but the answer to this can be obtained in hardly like 40 to 50 seconds. Okay, here while explaining, it will take more time. In exam, if you get such kind of sum, you will be able to answer the question in 40 to 50 seconds. Let us see how. There is a circular racetrack. Okay, A and B are starting at distinct points. We don't know they are starting where, standing where. Let the distance between A and B be X. What is the total length of the racetrack? 120 meters. Okay, total length of the racetrack is 120 meters. Distance between A and B is X. They run at the speeds of A meters per second and B meters per second. Now, why I have shown this to be running towards each other? Let us see that. They meet for the first time 16 seconds after they start. So they start the race or okay, from here and here. They meet after 16 seconds. Then second time, say for example, if they meet over here at this point, okay, say they meet at this point, then they'll what happened second time when they'll meet, B will be here, A will be here. Second time they'll meet somewhere over here or here. Here they have covered the entire track. To cover the entire track, okay, the time taken by them is 40 seconds from the start. So after the first meeting, they are taking 24 seconds. After the first meeting to cover the entire track, they are taking 24 seconds. Understood? Right? Now, if B is running in opposite direction than original, B is running over here, A is running as it is over here. Okay, I'll draw the diagram again. A and B. B is running in this direction, A is running in this direction. Distance between them is X. Over here, what is happening is B is running away, B is quicker and A is running away. So B has to cover all this and come over here. For it, he is taking 40 seconds, which is higher than 24 seconds or even 16 seconds. So that means that in the second case, B and A must be running in same direction. And in the first case where time required is less, A and B must be running it, must be running towards each other. Okay. So this is the answer. So that is the reason both of them are running towards each other. Now over here, we are going to use the concept of relative speed. What is the meaning of relative speed over here? First, I think so you might be knowing it, but still what I'm going to do is I'm going to still explain this to you. Okay. What is the meaning of relative speed? Take a look over here. Now this is my car and this is my house, right? My house is stationary. My car is moving at the speed of say 10 kilometers per hour. Okay. Okay. It's not a bullock cart, but still it's my car. I am a very safe driver. So my car is moving towards my house at the speed of 10 kilometers per hour, right? So distance over here is say D, time taken is T. Speed is given by distance upon time, correct? 10 will be equal to distance upon time. Speed is say S. Now, this is my car. This is my house. My house has wheels to it, right? Like the Bacardi ad. My car is moving towards the house. My house is also running away from me. We both are trying to, my house is also coming towards me. I am moving at the speed of S1. House is moving at the speed of S2. When two objects are moving, the speed does not remain S or S1, okay, or the car speed. How much is the time taken to meet or reach the house? Distance will be changing or distance will be how much? This same time taken we have to calculate, okay? Speed will be relative speed, okay? It will be some combination of S1 and S2. If we are moving towards each other, if I'm moving towards my house and my house is moving towards me, I will reach my house quickly. So speed has to be added, S1 plus S2, okay? If my house is running away from me and I am running after my house, so time required will be more. So that means speed has to be reduced. S1 minus S2. This is concept of relative speed. Over here, A and B are moving towards each other. So speed initially will be A plus B. How much is the distance covered by them? X. How much is the time taken for that? 16. Now we don't know X. We don't know A and B also. Let it be like that. Okay. Next. In the second case, after meeting for the first time. So after this case, what I'll do is I'll draw the diagram over here. This is A, this is B. They are running and both of them meet over here. So now B is running over here, A is running over here. Next time they meet over here. After how much time are they meeting? They are meeting after 24 seconds. Okay, here we have calculated. After 40 seconds from the time they start the race. So 40 seconds from this point or from this point where they meet for the first time, they are going to take 40 minus 16. 40 minus 16, 24 seconds. Okay, 16 seconds first they meet over here after 16 seconds and after 24 seconds they meet over here. So 40 seconds after they start the race from these points. When they meet over here, B is over here, A is over here. if you observe from this point to this point, they have covered the entire track length of 120 meters. So distance covered is 120 meters. Also, they are moving in opposite direction. So relative speed will be A plus B. So that comes out to be 5 meters per second. So A plus B is 5 meters per second. Put the value over here. What do you get? 5 into 16 comes out to be X. Distance covered, or the distance between A and B, will be 80 meters. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll draw over here A, B, distance between them is 80 meters. So what is the remaining distance? 120 minus 80, 40 meters. Now comes the second part. A is moving like this. B is moving like this. Same direction. B is quicker than A. So relative speed will be B minus A. Relative speed will be what? B minus A. Distance covered is how much? Take a look. For relative speed, now very important concept. I understand you might be knowing this. Still, I'm repeating for people who don't know. Over here, whenever two speeds are given, okay, we are moving in opposite, they are moving in same direction. How to find the distance covered? Very easy. Keep A stationary, keep B stationary on the same place. Fix them. Okay. Over here, what is the distance covered? B is quicker than A. So B will be catching up to A. This is the direction. So start moving from here. A is where? Over here. B is here. For B to catch up to A, how much distance has to be covered? 40. This is the distance. Keep A stationary. Speed we are taking relative only, B minus A, because B is quicker. If A was quicker, we'll take A minus B. B is quicker, so we take B minus A. But now we have to find the distance. So forget about speed. Keep both of them stationary at these places. B is moving in this direction and B is going to catch up to A. So to catch up to A, how much distance B has to cover or catch up? Not cover, catch up. Extra 40 meters B has to catch up. So distance covered is 40 in case of relative speed. How much time they have given? If B had started originally in the opposite direction than the original direction, they would have met for the first time after 40 seconds. Time taken would have been 40 seconds. B minus A is equal to 1 meters per second. Equation second, first equation is this. A plus B equal to 5. Add both of them. What do you get? This gets cancelled. 2B will be equal to 6. B comes out to be 3 meters per second. Answer is option A. This sum with various values has been asked in TCS. Okay. And even in other exams. Okay. In TCS Digital, this has been asked with different values. So over here, even if the values change, concept remains the same. Whatever I have taught you over here, it might have taken 10 minutes, but because I was teaching, 10 to 15 minutes, because I was teaching. But if you, when you try to solve this, hardly you'll require 1 minute to solve, because all the things like, okay, no, this, they must be moving in same direction. So we'll take A plus B equal to X by 16. And on the other side, while going, they cover the entire track. And that is 120 meters. But everything would be done in your mind, which is faster than your hand. Okay. So mind is faster than your hand. That calculation would be done in your mind. Writing would be done. Only this much part would be written by you, or over here, this and this part directly. Nothing of this sort would be there. Okay. Only one or two diagrams you will draw. So answer is 3 meters per second.